Hello, I'm a ninja, and this is my least favorite way to climb around. No, in reality I'm Arachne, and this is Strider, the Mega Drive version. So Capcom wanted to make a new type of action game, and made a very weird game. There's a dictator named Grandmaster, no flashes, and Iryu, a Strider, sets off to defeat him. Why Iryu? Well, because he's a powered up and futuristic version of Ryu from Street Fighter. I power you, I Ryu, I Ryu. Yep, that's the whole thing, and also because he's strong. Well, yeah, that too. Oh, and that's not it. The name Ryu is gonna be used again by Capcom, but more on that at a later date. Gameplay-wise, I'm very mixed on this game. On one hand, you have good movement and an attack with a nice range. You can move pretty well, climb everywhere, grapple onto stuff, move up through certain ceilings. This all feels very good to perform. On the other hand, the stages and the bosses aren't really well programmed. The levels don't communicate very well at all what you can climb on or what is simply a death pit you can't save yourself from. Because you can keep living sometimes, but other times that is the only answer, I guess. Inconsistency! That's what we like to see in video games. And on the bosses there's a whole another problem. Hitboxes! What I'm showing you right now is a mini boss in the second level, a robot ape. When they do this uppercut move, they might hit you, even when they clearly didn't touch you. That's some very good programming, Capcom, totally not a bad thing. I swear I like this game a little. I love to move Iryu around, but everything else is painful. Staying on the stages, here's some classic weirdness of old games for ya. I was having the hardest time of my entire playthrough during just the very second level. Between enemy placement, stage traps and bosses, including that fucking ape, I felt like I knew every texture before I managed to pass. It's bad because the successive two stages were a breeze compared to this. Did nobody balance their stages from easier to hardest back in the day? Did they find level 2 easy? I've played this game for the first time in 6 years, so I'm not an expert on Strider. But hey, when I take 30 minutes on stage 2 and then 10 minutes on the 3rd and the 4th one combined, maybe something went wrong. Art style wise is not that great for me. The stages have coloring problems that cause me not to understand what's on screen and get killed by an enemy that was hidden by the giant sprite of my sword attack. It's just so bizarre how the enemies are so well animated and are distinct, and the rest of Strider does his darnest to hide them or make them impossible to see. And finally, something without problems. In 1990, this was one of the earliest examples of how to use the Sega Mega Drive sound chip right, aside from OutRun and a couple other exceptions. They sound very good and not grating in any kind of way, at least on this front, Capcom remains the same. Also, they're used in a very peculiar way. During stages, there are multiple checkpoints, and since the levels are so long, it might take a split second to load the next part. Sometimes that gap is also used to load another song without having to resort to a fade to black. You'll end up hearing multiple tracks in every level. That was invigorating and a good motivation to keep going when you get stuck on a particular section of Strider. I, at least, wanted to hear if the music changed or not at the next checkpoint, so that helped me for sure. In the end, Capcom made a decent effort, but I can't honestly say that it deserved more than a 6 out of 10. Hey, at least the sequels get better and better each time. Also, this inspired them to make Devil May Cry alongside Resident Evil, so there's that.
If
you wanna see me play the games that I will review plus some extra stuff, catch me on Twitch at ArachniRetro, same name that I use on Twitter where I will keep you updated with everything I am doing and more. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!